Tarde.
Single Fella by Judith Bomberstaffa, illustrated by Julie Durrell. Single Lad in the Cab. He is single fella. He mocks a lot. We see Tom and Tim. Tom and Tim like Tom like to nap. Single fella has to mock for them. Single fella, said the top.
Tom.
Mock the map, single fella. Hook to it fast. Cinderella was sad. She did not like to hook and hook. She was not fast. Tap, tap, tap. It was Tom. He had a map. The map had a rat on it.
Diam.
Hi, said Tom. You like the rat on my map? Did you see him? Yes, yeah, said Tom. I'm the rat? No, he's not, said Tim. I'm the rat on the map. Tap. See the shoe in my lap. See, Tam. It is from my lap. See if the shoe fits you. Tom, foot was fat. Was fat. The shoe did not fit them. The shoe is not for you, see. Goodbye. Tap, tap, tap. It was fun. She was lost. He said, Pam, see my map. The lad is on it. Is he in? No, said Tom and Tim. Yes, and the fella said to them.
The map is in. I don't get. Yeah, I don't get this.
Will you keep your hands to yourself?
See the shoe in my lap, said Pam. It fits my left foot. See if she fit you. Cinderella said his foot was not fat. The shoe fit his foot.
Jennifer, and what are you doing?
My foot fills the shoe, said Cinderella. He said the light on my mat. Said Pam, I like him.
Just hug.
Just hug yourself. Yeah,
okay.
Not like that.
Don't ever.
You just do this.
Yeah.
That's.
Quiet.
Yes.
Start.
The title is A box can be many things. This box is junk, Mom says. Then William and Louis came. And William says, this box is not junk. We can use it as many things. We can use it as a cake. We can use it as a house. This box can be a racing car. Louis says. Then they rip more and then they rip and William says no.
too much book.
By Rowan Randall, illustrated by Emma Dodd. Postman Pete jumped out of bed. Hooray, he said. It's my birthday. I can't wait to see how many birthday cards I get. At the post office, Postman Pete sorted the mail and filled his sack. But there were no cards in it. Perhaps I'll get some when I deliver the mail, he thought. Good morning, Horace Fern, said Postman Pete. I have some letters and a parcel for you today. It's my new flower pot, said Fern. Thank you, Postman Pete. And with that, she went inside. No birthday card? Thought Postman Pete. Perhaps in my next shop. Good morning, PC Polly, said Postman Pete. At the police station. I have some letters and a postcard for you today. It's from my friend Pipa in Peru. Thank you, Postman Pete. And with that, she went back to her work. No birthday card? But Postman Pete with a sigh. Perhaps at my next shop. Good morning, Mr. Baker, said Pete. I have three letters and a parcel for today. It's my new rolling pin, said Mr. Baker. Thank you, Postman Pete. And with that, he carried on with his work. No birthday card here either. Postman Pete, very lovely. The last two letters in Postman Pete's sack are Fireman Curtis. I hope Curtis is a birthday card for me, he thought. The Fireman Curtis had nothing from Postman Pete. Postman Pete felt very sad. Everyone has forgotten my birthday, he thought. As he walked home, but when he got to his house, surprise! Everyone was there. Cards and presents and a big birthday card. Happy birthday, Postman Pete. Postman Pete opened his presents and shared his cake with everyone. This is the best birthday I've ever had, he said. The end.
Frog's Lunch, written by Dee Lillygard, illustrated by Jerry Zimmerman. Frog was sitting on a lily pad in the middle of the pond. It's lunchtime, said Frog. Along came a fly. Lunch, said Frog. The fly was buzzing around. Frog sat very still on his lily pad in the middle of the pond. The fly buzzed and buzzed around Frog. Buzz, buzz, said the fly. Frog sat very, very still. Frog's eyes grew big. The fly came closer and closer to Frog. Snap! Frog snapped
up.
Good lunch, said
Frog.
Good day.
Okay.
Frog's Lunch, written by Dean Lillygard, illustrated by Jerry Zimmerman. Frog was sitting on a lily pad in a middle.
Wait.